If you are creating an e-learning program, online course, or virtual training that you are planning on selling to your learners, meaning that your learners are not just your learners, they're also your customers, then you have probably figured out that in addition to a learning management system, a piece of technology that you need to house your course, where you need to host your course so you can deliver it to your learners, you also need some other pieces of technology to help you with the marketing. Now, the great thing is there is this technology called Kajabi that not only hosts and houses your course, but it also takes care of all of the marketing channels as well. And the most important marketing tool that you have for your business is your email list and building out email campaigns for your email list. And that's what we're gonna talk about today in this video. Welcome to the eLearning Simplified YouTube channel. My name is Johnny Havey. I am one of the co-founders of eLearning Partners, the organization that created eLearning Simplified for you. The focus of this channel is to simplify eLearning for you so that you can focus on creating remarkable content for your learners while you look to us to help you build out the perfect and simplest program for you and your team to understand and for your learners to access. Now, if you are interested in the software we are talking about today, the technology we are talking about today is called Kajabi. We have a link in the description below this video. That is our affiliate link. So if you click on it, you will be showing that you support us, which is awesome because no matter if you go through our link or you go directly to the Kajabi site, you are going to pay the same amount of money. The cool thing is you may also, depending on when you do this, get an extra 14 days of a free trial using Kajabi. Usually it's a 14-day free trial. If you use our affiliate link certain times during the year, you will get a 28-day free trial, which is super cool. And then you're showing your support to us and the channel. Now, let's dive in. Email lists. Why are email lists so important? Now, we talk about this in a lot of videos, and it is important to be repetitive because of how important this is. It took us years to really figure out, oh, emails really are the most important asset that your company owns is the email list. Now, do you own the emails themselves? Not necessarily, but you own the list that they live on. And the more people, the more qualified emails you have on that list, the more money your organization will be able to make and the more people you'll be able to help. So email lists are so important because no matter what marketing channel you're talking about, let's use PPC as an example. Let's say you're paying for ads to sell your digital product. And let's say that you're paying for an ad that is sending people to a sales page for your online course. And let's say that that sales page doesn't have an email capture form on it. That's not good. Because what's going to happen is people, you're going to spend X amount of money for that click. They're going to hit your sales page. Most of the people that hit that sales page aren't going to buy. Most, like 99% of people aren't going to buy. So 99% of those people, let's say you have 100 people, 99 people out of 100 are just going to bounce. And you spent money on this click and you got zero value out of it. Maybe that 1% actually purchased from you. Fine. That's exciting. But what would be even cooler is if you paid for that ad and they hit a page that isn't selling your product. Instead, it is a page giving away a free giveaway, a free high value giveaway that these people searching these key terms or seeing these ads on social media would really connect with. And in order to get the free giveaway, they have to input their email. The crazy thing is, the data shows that you're going to be in the 20 to 30% range of people that click on that ad and hit that site that captures their email. You're going to capture 20 to 30% of those people's emails by having that opt-in form. Well, on the other hand, 1% at best is going to purchase your course when they hit that page. 20 to 30% are guaranteed to opt into that form. And now you have an email address that you can nurture with the first type of email campaign, a nurture campaign, and eventually sell to the second type of email campaign, a sales campaign. That's why it's so valuable. And here's another example. Let's say that you spend years building out your Facebook page. And then all of a sudden, Facebook changes their algorithm and it goes from you having 20, 30, 40, 50,000 people who like your Facebook page or follow you are no longer seeing your content. Because all of a sudden, they're only showing your content to 1% of the people that follow you. This could happen. This has happened for some people. Now that asset that you've built up no longer is allowing you to showcase your products or your services to the community that you've built on that platform. And this applies to any social media platform. This applies to search engine optimization as well, where you could spend all this time trying to rank for a keyword, then all of a sudden Google changes the algorithm and you're no longer on the first page. What do you do? That's why no matter what marketing channel you're using, your end goal needs to be to capture an email address. And why not house all your courses and your digital products on the same e-learning technology that also has your email list and all the email marketing capabilities to take those emails on the list, put it into a marketing funnel, a marketing and sales funnel, and convert them into learners. So here's what we have. E-learning campaigns. Now, Kajabi is really cool where you can connect the email campaigns to the forms, to the landing pages, all in one platform. We have multiple videos on our channel talking about the different tools that Kajabi has and how everything integrates together. But just the email campaign alone, having this in addition to a place where you can build your courses and build your website and your landing pages is a game changer because you can manage it all in the same place where you're actually delivering your products as well. So here's what it looks like. There's a couple different ways to create an email campaign. You can create an email broadcast, which is like a one-off email that you send to your current subscriber base. So let's say you have 10,000 people on your list. What you can do is once a week, if you're building out your nurture sequence, which I'll define a little further in a second, for the first time, then you can send out an email broadcast. You can also set up an email sequence, which this could be one email, this could be 100 emails, that your list automatically goes through on a daily basis, could be twice a day, it could be twice a week, could be once a month. However you want to do it, you can set all that up in Kajabi. Now, before we dig into an email broadcast and email sequence any further, let's talk about the two types of email campaigns. First one is a nurture campaign. A nurture campaign, the goal of a nurture campaign is for you to stay in front of your list. So you could have a list, right? You could have 10,000 people on your list, but if you never email them, you're not going to get any value out of the list. And your list isn't going to get any value out of being on it either. It'd be kind of like having a Facebook page that has 100,000 subscribers or a YouTube channel that has 100,000 subscribers or 10,000 subscribers and you never put out new content. It's like, what's the point in having that many people on your list if you're not sending them valuable content? Now, the goal of content for a nurture campaign isn't to sell. The nurture campaign is to continuously provide value. So our nurture campaign for our company, we put out YouTube videos every week and we send out emails about them. And it's because every YouTube video we create is high value for our list. Our list is all people and businesses who are looking to create a e-learning program, either internal or external. So all the information we put out is for that community. Now, the cool thing about a nurture campaign is you are going to get people to unsubscribe who really don't care about the value you're bringing anyway, which means that you're not going to sell to them anyway. So that's the cool thing about a nurture campaign as well, is it weeds out the people who are never going to buy from you because they're just going to unsubscribe because they're going to get tired of you sending them this free valuable content and be like, ah, God, I don't want this. And then they get off the list. That's one reason why people are like, oh, I don't want to broadcast to my list like that often. I don't want to send them an email every week. Well, you want to. You want to make sure that you're sending an email to your list at least monthly, but really at least weekly. Because think about it this way. even if they don't ever open the email, they're going to see eLearning Partners. Then a week later, eLearning Partners. And then when they want to build out a course or they want to purchase a course related to building out a course, who are they going to think about? eLearning Partners. Same thing. I subscribe to multiple email lists, one of those being Viori, which is a brand that I really like in the activewear space for the past 3, 4, or 5 years. The cool thing is, do I open every email? No. But one or two times a year, their email hits my mailbox and I'm like, oh yeah, I should probably buy some Viori clothes. And I go to their website and I buy. I don't really open their emails, but I stay on the list because I like to know, hey, is there going to be a sale at some point? They have some cool podcasts and stuff they do too. Same thing. Don't plan on people opening every one of your emails. If people open two of your emails a year, you've done your job, or one email a year. But that's the cool thing about a nurture campaign. The goal of a nurture campaign isn't to sell, it's to stay in front of those people. You have 10,000 people on your list. You could either make 10,000 phone calls or send one email broadcast a week. And now you have a touch point with them every week, which is really cool. The other type of email campaign is a sales campaign. The goal of a sales campaign is to sell, which means that you have to ask for the sale. Now, a sales campaign could be 3 emails, could be 5 emails, it could be 7 emails, it could be 30 emails. There's a ton of different ways to do it. If you're just starting out, keep it simple. Start with five high value emails. The first couple aren't going to ask for the sale. They're going to start talking about some value. And then 3, 4, and 5 are asking for the sale. And when we say asking for the sale, we mean there needs to be call to actions in the emails that take them to a sales page. All that can be built in the Kajabi. So let's look at it here. Email broadcasts and an email sequence. Like we said, if you're building a nurture campaign for the first time, use the email broadcast. Whenever we put out a new piece of YouTube content, we use an email broadcast. And then what we do with those broadcasts is we put them into an email sequence for new people that join our email list later after that broadcast has happened. But if you are building a nurture campaign for the first time, which means maybe you're building out 52 emails for the year, you may as well use an email broadcast. Email sequence, on the other hand, is going to allow you, here, let's see, let's do a test sequence here, to decide when emails are sent. So let's say that people fill out a form on your site, and when they fill out the form, there's an automation that says, send this email. And then what you can do is you can literally say, 1 day later, so I'm going to add a new email. So I'm going to say, 1 day later, I want to send another email. 1 week later, I want to send another email. So I'm going to say day zero is actually going to be immediate. So when you say day zero in Kajabi, that means that they're going to get it immediate. So if I go back to my sequence here, we're going to see that we have a day zero, which is immediately, and we have a day one. I can also do, I want to send one a week later. So I'm going to do this, get started, create, and I'm going to say, I want to send one 7 days later. I'm going to send one 30 days later. You can sequence when they're going to be sent. So what's really cool is I can go into these now, and there's going to be some text, call to action. If we're doing a sales email sequence, you want this call to action to be very obvious, like purchase. And then you can take it to a landing page, checkout page, download a file, all sorts of stuff. You can tell Kajabi where you want people to go when they click on the call to action. So it's really easy. Really, the basics of this is you're going to have text blocks. You're going to have a call to action block. You can add image blocks and stuff too, but keep it simple. Keep it simple. Simpler is better. The main goal of a sales email campaign is you want people to easily be able to go to your website so that they can make that purchase decision and send them to the sales page. Don't necessarily send them to the homepage of your website. Send them to the page that has the deal on it about your digital product that you're trying to sell. All right. So let's go to an email broadcast now. So that's an email campaign. If I go to email broadcast, continue, same thing. I pick a template, tons of templates here. Let's do simple text, get started, have a name for it, create. Then you choose who's going to receive the broadcast, all people. You have members of different memberships. You can have a custom segment. Pretty cool. Edit content. So we go save, continue, edit content, and then we save, continue, and then you schedule it. So you decide when you want to send it out. So those are the two ways to create. See, I can send it out right now, or I can send it at a later date. Pretty cool. So those are the two ways to create emails in Kajabi. Really, the biggest takeaway here is get people on your email list. Have a continuous nurture campaign. Email at the very least once a month, but please email weekly. And it, as long as there's value in the email, that's all that matters. Open rates aren't that important when it comes to a nurture sequence. You just want it to provide value and continuously be in your learners and prospective learners' mailbox at least once a month, more preferably once a week. We send out at least one email a week, and we create at least one YouTube video a week to nurture our audience. Then the other email sequence is the sales email sequence. And remember, it could be as simple as 3 to 5 emails with a direct ask for the sale with a call to action, going to your sales page on your website that you can also create in Kajabi, where people can easily purchase your product. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel. And if you really want to figure out what software is best for you and your e-learning program, or how to speak to your learners, how to create this content that your learners are going to connect with in your emails, on your YouTube channel, if you want to figure out what your learners actually care about, what kind of content they care about, we have a free masterclass linked below this video. And in that masterclass, we talk about how to guarantee the success of your e-learning program. Well, guaranteeing the success is that your learners actually engage in it and use your program, which means that if you're selling your program, you're actually getting sales. Well, how do you get sales? Well, you get sales by really knowing who your learners are. So we're gonna teach you how to define your learners, how to figure out what their challenges are. You're gonna learn how to build content around that, because we're going to give you a step-by-step process of what to do once you define your learners. And part of that is figuring out how to best nurture that list and in the end have that successful sales sequence, that successful email sales sequence, to turn them into paid customers. So we'll see you in the next video.
So a big question that you may be asking yourself right now is, should I develop my own website? Should I create a website on WordPress and hard code the learning management system that I use onto my new website? Those are really critical questions that will save you a lot of time and money if you understand how to utilize a software that already integrates a website builder within, that will make you, your life, and your team's life a lot easier.